last topic. In this segment, I thought we'd end with a little would you rather game. So I'm going to hit you up with a few would you rather scenarios that put you in a tight spot, and then we'll discuss the ludicrous events of such scenarios. Okay, so let's go with the first one. Just switch to my other documents to read. All right, so the first one is, would you rather never eat chocolate again or legally change your last name to Hitler and not be able to change it back? So, chocolate or Hitler?
What about chocolate flavored things like ice cream?
I think that's I'll give you a pass if it doesn't. It's one of those things that doesn't taste like chocolate. You know how when you taste like strawberry ice cream, it doesn't actually taste like strawberries. So I'll give you a pass on that. But anything that actually tastes like chocolate is out of the running. Even if it's synthetic, it's not actually chocolate.
That means you can never have chocolate cake again.
Yeah, no chocolate cake. No chocolate Cadbury's.
I'd go for Hitler.
No cream eggs.
Straight up.
Yeah, I'd go. I think I'd go Hitler as well, because you can always just be like, "It's not my fault, dude. I was born
that way.
To fucking that lineage." So, you know, wasn't a choice, right?
Yeah, I'd quite happily go for Hitler. Like,
I wouldn't shave my fucking facial hair to have a little fucking dodgy tash.
Yeah, it's not like I'm gonna walk around with like a frigging side sweeped hair or anything, is it? Like, on top of it and. You know, you start shouting in.
It'd just be one of those. You'd be the butt of the joke, and you get a lot of banter for it, and you'd get a lot of odd looks at like doctor's appointments. But aside from that,
only legal documents.
For 99.9% of your life, it's not going to be an issue. Whereas chocolate, yeah. That's going to crop up way more often than
I can't
you
go,
being
like, a couple of days without chocolate. So, like,
yeah,
I'd give me Hitler.
Yeah, I'll go Hitler. What about you, Lou? Chocolate or Hitler?
The same. I think you could live with it. It's not the most tasteful thing, but like Eddie Hitler in Bottom, you wore it well.
Yeah. Exactly. You just gotta, you know, have a bit of swag with it, and you'll be all right. Roll with a bit of swagger.
Never thought I'd hear Hitler and swag in the same line.
Is Hitler all round? Right, let's schnell on to the next topic then, shall we? Right. Would you rather... Not next topic. Would you rather, you know what I'm saying. Would you rather save the life of a starving African child you'll never meet or have a real working lightsaber? Choices. Thoughts then, people?
You just kind of escalated a little bit.
Oh, dear. There shouldn't be... a dilemma there, should there?
There's going to be difficult questions.
As bad as it sounds, I'm going to say this. I would save the starving, dying child. Like, not mainly, but one of the underlying reasons is because you guys know me, and I'm going to take off my own arm or something with that. You know it's going to happen.
That is true.
So, yeah.
Oh, God. I'd save the kid, but I'd be bitter about it for the rest of my
life. Yeah. Mm.
You'd find out who he is just to send him hate mail or whatever. Be like, I saved your life, but I resent you for it. My thoughts is this goes two ways. Yeah, it's either like you. Obviously, my first instinct is to save the starving African child. But what if that lightsaber had technologies that could push forward the human race and save that countless thousands of lives going forward? So it's kind of a balancing act. But off the top of my head,
what if that
isn't it kind of an instrument of death? I'm not sure. It
yeah, true. But think about the technology inside of it, that energy source, the amount of power it must be giving out. It can cut through steel metal, and all in the size of a flashlight tube. You know, energy-wise, it could solve the world's energy problems, and then
translate into something. Star Wars lore. I think it's some kind of crystal. Anybody can use it, but only if you've got lots of midichlorians can you use it well.
Yeah, but it doesn't matter whether you use it well, because if you implement it into a different sort of technology, then maybe But I would pick the saving the starving African child, because A, because you'd have to live with your choices if you pick the lightsaber, and B, I'm not 100% sure that the lightsaber would have any other real world applications like you're saying. So on those two bases, I would go with the African child. But like you're saying, I'd be so bitter. So bitter.
Who would you fight with if you only had one as well?
You wouldn't. Oh, I wouldn't need to fight anyone. I'd just go around cutting stuff. Everything. I cut everything with it. Oh, I'm gonna have a sandwich. I'm gonna have a sandwich. I'll get an old fashioned loaf that's not sliced. I'll cut my own. Oh, toast.
Old fashioned.
You could instantly toast. Toast.
I don't think you'd get toast.
I think you'd get like a massive, like half of the loaf, like in. Yeah, exactly. It's not like a piece of paper, Nathan. It's like
you'd have holes in all your counters and stuff, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
Burn marks all around your house, but it'd be fucking worth it.
Maybe marshmallows, but not toast. Toasted marshmallows would work.
It'd be good stuff. All right, let's do another. Would you rather live in a world where there is peace and order, or live in a world where you rule? So, there is no question asked. You rule the world. It's completely your choice what happens. Or a world where there is peace and order.
I don't think that's a hard one. I don't think I'm cut out for that.
Yeah, but you don't have to. You don't have to deal with the nitty gritty. You could be like a queen.
You can do
and
whatever
you
want.
Chill. You could just chill, and you'd be like, you're prime minister. You figure all that out, all that clever shit. But you do what I tell you. So you could have it like that.
I'd probably end up with, even if I did have someone to do my bidding, I'd probably end up have like some massive, like, I don't know, revolution against me for doing stupid stuff. That's pretty much my answer for everything, is just to, you know.
yeah, I'm not cool. So I think that's a no-brainer.
Yeah, but part of the thing is you won't ever be overrun. You see, it can go two ways, though, because if you ruled the world, you could set a precedent and make it so there is peace and order. So if you were, you know, skilled or whatever enough, you could have both.
You're not just ruling one country, so there's not other countries that could oppose against you. So if you ran the whole world, you could say, hang on, mate, like, you know, get yourself in order.
It probably would cut out war to a degree, but there could still be rebellions, per se, even though you could never be overthrown. It could never get to such a degree. I suppose there could still be terrorism, as it would be classified or whatever.
Yeah, but you've ruled the world, I'm going to change my answer.
I think, again, I'd have to. I kind of want to rule the world, being a megalomaniac. I really want to, but I think I'd have to pick peace and order and then be bitter again, because I'm not convinced that
I'm going to rule the world and I'm going to gloat.
Oh, dear.
And if I'm ruling the world, Nathan, you're in so much trouble.
I'll be part of the Freedom Fighter organization. Even if we can never overthrow you, we'll still be there, you know.
We'll take you out.
What?
See?
Oh, I thought you had
already
back.
I've already got one to my cause, so.
I have got your back, but it's got a dagger in it.
What? Mark, do you know what?
It's cold as ice, see?
Loyalty.
And it only took. It took me like 10 seconds to get my first person to join my cause. And she's already stabbed you in the back.
All right, let's play a would you rather.
You're
Louise.
In trouble.
Would you rather live with me for a week or live with Nathan for a week?
I've lived with both of you for way too long.
In a confined space.
What, in an elevator? Trapped in an elevator with one
All right then. Yeah, who would you rather be trapped in an elevator with?
Nathan, we'd find a way out.
Oh, that's not fair.
Plus,
I've
got games on my phone as
if
well.
If I was with you, I'd have to eat you because you probably taste like chocolate. You just said you can't go 2 days without it.
That's a fair point. Did you choose? What did you choose, though? You chose Hitler, all right. You can have her if she tastes like chocolate. If you'd have chose chocolate, you couldn't eat her, you know.
No, I choose Hitler. She chose chocolate, so ha!
She tastes like chocolate, you can't eat her if she actually tastes like chocolate.
But if I taste like artificial chocolate, that's okay.
That's all right, yeah.
I'll eat her anyway, she'll be delicious.
Yep.
And then I'll string bones together to make a rope ladder to get out of the elevator shaft.
You are cutthroat. Like,
cold as ice.
Do you have no shame?
moving along.
Yeah.
Right. You'll like this next one anyway. Would you rather live in the Harry Potter universe but have the same social standing as now, therefore your magical equivalent, or be a billionaire with unparalleled social standing and all the trappings, and if you choose to do good with it, all the good that can come from that. So what would you rather have? You would basically be like, you know...
What do we equate to in the Harry Potter world?
Well, I don't know. What is the average... you two are more into Harry Potter than I am. So what's the average person like in Harry Potter? That's what you'd be. You wouldn't be some fucking... People.
They're still muggles.
Yeah.
Is it? Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you mean like in like, you know, as in like...
In wizard society.
Imagine the Harry Potter magic is we live in that dimension or whatever where...
No muggles.
You know, where magic, we're not muggles, or we live in that reality.
Yeah.
But it's us as we are now in that reality with whatever our skill set is now comparable. Do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah, so we're living our everyday lives just with magic around us.
Yeah.
Just like, oh, I need to make some toast. Zing.
Well, I don't know if it is like that, but yeah, for the average person. But yeah, if it is like that,
I think,
you know, exactly like that.
We'd all be like the equivalent of Neville Longbottom.
That is lame.
Yeah. That's great.
But
well, you might not even be that good. If you're saying there's a lot of people who aren't wizards per se, you might be like Hagrid, who isn't a wizard, but you know, he knows he's got a wand and he knows a few tricks of the trade and whatnot. So, you know, what would you rather be in that universe as an average, you know, an average person, or the king of the regular world? Not literally, but you know
I'll
what
take
I mean.
All the money.
Captain of industry,
and
all that
I'll,
sort of
I'll
stuff.
I'll just move into the Harry Potter world, Universal Studios, and like actors to behave that way.
Oh yeah, you could do that.
I like Lou's idea. That's fantastic. That would be so lame if like literally all I could use my magic.
Just live in your own delusion.
Or like hoovering. That's what I'm saying. Like, if I'm
I don't need to worry about that. I've got the lightsaber.
No, you chose against the lightsaber.
I know. Damn that African child. Oh.
The hate has started already.
No, it's not hate. It's just mild resent.
Just mild.
So what would you pick then? Harry Potter or billionaire?
I'll take the money.
I think on Lou's principle, I'd probably take the money. How like if I'm in the Harry Potter?
How weird is this? I picked the Harry Potter universe. The two bigger Harry Potter fans take the money in the social standing, and I'd rather live in the magical world. How ironic is that?
All right, let's spin it a different way then. I know we've got a lot in the real world to like deal with fear-wise, but can you imagine having Voldemort in your world? No thanks.
He's still in this world. It's just you don't know about him.
That's fine.
I mean, you can say ignorance is bliss.
That's fine.
But you know. Your billions won't help if Voldemort comes to try and fucking steal your soul or
what. Well, they're not going to help before I can do her magic is make toast. Either way, I lose.
That's a good point. You wouldn't just be able to make toast. I don't know. What's the average person like in that universe?
Just like anyone. Just middle class.
Surely they've got a few tricks. Surely they can at least Wingardium Leviosa.
Leviosa, not Leviosa. Yeah, I guess, but like... You don't really see a lot of like the middle class muggles or whatever wizards in Harry Potter. You see like obviously like Ron's family, which is like lower class.
I mean,
but
you'd have to think Hogwarts is basically Hogwarts would be like Eton or one of these, you know, swanky private schools. Really, we wouldn't have gone to Hogwarts because we're just like the average Joe Schmo. So
yeah, no, because it's the only school, isn't it? Hogwarts is. There's no like.
No, there's
like,
several.
Oh, is there? Oh, yeah, of course, because there is.
Don't they have that Tri-Wizards thing where all the schools come together?
Yeah.
I thought you two were big in... I see, I know more about Harry Potter than you fucking
Well, Voldemort's, like, mother and her family were the equivalent of wizard hillbillies.
Was it?
Yeah, which is not so great.
Oh, right, I thought he came from lineage.
No. No one was so bitter.
So, like, they're complete tramps. So, yeah, it may not go so well. Whereas you're talking about being a billionaire.
Mm.
Yeah, it's not just a billionaire. You've got unparalleled social standing as well. So,
I guess because we know, like, a little bit more and stuff. Like, we, as much as we see the good side, we also see, like, the bad side. Whereas you're just all, like, fame and, let's be a wizard. You're a wizard, Nathan.
I don't care about that. I'm more interested in the magic. Like I said, I wouldn't probably have got sent to Hogwarts. So I'd be at some state school, wouldn't I? We didn't have swanky education, so I wouldn't have gone to Hogwarts. So.
But no, saying that though, if Ron Weasley can afford to go to like Hogwarts, then you'd be able to.
Yeah, but there's those schools that have what are they called? You know.
Oh yeah, yeah. Like
where you don't have to be rich, but they've got
like a scheme, haven't they? Like where they someone kind of scholarship, yeah.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah.
Maybe.
So maybe he got in on one of. Oh, his dad knows people, don't he? He's in the not institute, whatever the
Ministry.
Fuck it's called.
Ministry. Of
yeah.
Music.
He knows people. He just greased a few elbows or whatever the saying is. So.
Greased a few elbows. Is this like your clever boots, Nathan?
I think it is. Yeah.
What, are we getting one a week now?
Yeah, one a week. It's a weekly quota.
Greasy elbows.
Oh, greasy elbows and clever boots over there. All right, on to the next one then. Would you rather live through either the zombie apocalypse or through nuclear fallout? But I'm going to get fucking lambasted. I always say that wrong. Nuclear, because I always say nuclear, but it's pronounced nuclear anyway. Would you rather go through nuclear fallout, surviving within a stronghold capable of withstanding either? So you're in a stronghold, you can either withstand the nuclear fallout or the zombie apocalypse. You might have to still do runs and things to live in that world, but you're in a stronghold.
I will take the zombies, because if you watch any zombie like series or anything like that, especially like The Walking Dead, you always know that it's the bastard humans that are the problems. So if you're going on a run, I'd take on a zombie rather than taking on a human, and there's going to be a lot more humans to deal with.
Also, I've played too much Fallout, and it generally goes wrong. There's a strong chance you'll mutate into something nasty.
It always goes terrible. I don't think radiation really works like that, but yeah, I get what you're saying. I've seen The Road, which is
the most
depiction
movie
of
ever.
The Road is the most depressing. I was talking about
this, and that's based on nuclear fallout.
Depressing.
It's based on winter. What's it called? Nuclear winter.
Mm. Yeah.
So that would be a thing, and that world looks incredibly bleak. Fucking like you're saying, depressing and bleak. So.
Well, yeah, that's the thing. You always, like, in the movies and stuff like that, I've got all that kind of stuff going on. It's always depressing. There's never any hope. But at least in, you know, the zombie world, like, you know, there's a lot of hope and rebuilding civilization and
I'm not sure there's hope.
Well, there is a little
bit. It's much cooler.
The world itself
the only film...
isn't damaged. It'd probably be better off.
You can still grow, like,
the only film
clean water.
I can think of that does, nuclear fallout in a more
optimistic.
You know, I don't know, livable way is the Book of Eli. In it's bad, but it's not as dreadful as something like The Road. There are still people living in that world and getting by day to day.
Look how horrible them people are though.
Yeah,
look what civilizations are built.
You'd get that in the zombie apocalypse as well though, to be fair.
Yeah, of course, but there'd be less of them to deal with, because one stab to the head and you're dead. Like, the zombies are dead. If a zombie, at the end of the day, if a zombie gets you, then, alright, it might be quite gruesome and griffit, when they get you. Or you'll turn into a zombie and you ain't got a clue what's going on. But if you get, held by, a big gang of, burly men and stuff, it's but not going to be very fun, is it?
Yeah, I think for me, I would pick the zombie apocalypse, because they're both going to be terrible in practical terms. I mean, we've said before, you always have a pie in the sky or see things through rose-tinted glasses. But I think the good moments that you'd have, those like moments of epic win in a nuclear fallout scenario, are few and far between. Whereas at least you can have fun in the zombie apocalypse at times, like raiding gun shops, like in Dawn of the Dead. That's going to be fucking hella cool. Going through some fucking old, shopping centre or whatever. Just raiding all the
good
cool
times.
Shit. Even bashing in zombies' brains, for a little bit. That's going to be mildly amusing.
I think
we're
unanimous on that one.
What? About, it's fun to cave in zombies' heads? Did you kill small animals, children?
They're not alive though. You're doing them a mercy. If I was a zombie, I'd rather you kill me than leave me to fucking roam the earth any day.
There's been no experiments on zombies or anything really, has there? What if zombies aren't dead? What if zombies have some weird... Because they go into it, and I can't remember what it was in.
Unless the world holds on a lot better than it does in the films, you're never going to have the potential to find out, because you're never going to have the resources or the capabilities. So you have to go on a survival mentality as opposed to what if and maybe. You know, if you had those resources, then maybe you could, you know, be a little bit more softly. But up until that point, you got to cave some fucking zombie skulls. It's just the way it's got to go, so...
Yeah,
you may as well enjoy your work, you know. So, you know,
you're really starting to worry me. Evil laugh.
I didn't pick to rule the world; you did. So I don't know why you're fucking.
Human race is like, it's probably not the best choice for human race, really. But I'll have fun.
Mrs. Hitler's gonna rule the world.
Yeah,
with lots of chocolate
and a lightsaber.
I didn't choose the lightsaber, did I? No, I didn't.
Oh, an African sidekick.
Yeah, exactly. See, I've got a beautiful little world building up around me. Exactly. You're just jealous.
A beautiful little zombie world.
Yes, with chocolate and starving. Well, they won't be starving at African children, because they'll be diabetic instead.
Well, one of them won't be. Anyway,
I'm not just gonna feed that one child and let everyone else
eat that
start.
One and kill all the others. Right?
You might do, you know. Hitler is your last name, so
whatever.
Might be a bit of a psychopath. Right, let's do another one then. Would you rather be able to change the size of an object without changing its weight, or vice versa, change the weight of an object but the size stays the same? So.
What?
I'd imagine there's a bit of confusion there. So basically, let's say you've got a pebble. You can either change the size of it to whatever size you want and the weight will stay the same. Or you can take any object and change the weight of it. So you could take a 2-ton truck and make it weigh 2 grams and pick it up with your hand. Or, well, anyone could. Or you could take a pebble and make it as big as a boulder, but it would weigh the same. Or you could take a bit of food and make it really big, so maybe then you could feed all, you know, feed people who haven't got enough to eat or whatever. So
choose,
but why to any of it?
Why not?
A superpower happened. It's a new super movie. Weight Man.
I'd choose the one where you can change the weight without changing the size.
Yeah.
Because you've got, like, if stuff's heavy, you can just, like, move around. I'm lazy, so that'd be perfect for me. And then you could, prank people massively. They're on the phone, or, like, they've got something in the pocket, change that, and then they're just crumpled on the floor. It's great.
It'd be quite fun leaving 50-ton-pound coins all over the floor as well.
Yeah, people would never be able to pick up. So.
Or, like, if... yeah, no, pranking, I think that'd be quite good.
I think for me, I'd pick the weight one as well, because I was thinking, how cool a superpower would it be? If anyone ever messed with you, you could carry like a baseball or something in your pocket. It doesn't weigh anything, but if anyone ever gave you any beef, you just throw it at them, and just before you let it go from your hand, you change the weight to like 5 kilograms or something, and it just sparks them out. So it'd be like a super cool power. And maybe you could change other things, like if you could change the weight of yourself at will.
I was just going to say that.
Maybe you could like jump really far, or
that's literally what I was just gonna say. You could I don't know. Maybe you could then like make some weird contraption.
I mean, they're both superpowers to a degree, because you could take a matchstick and grow it so it grows and just sparks someone out because it grows so fast or whatever. But I think I'd rather go with a weight one personally.
Yeah, you could, if you're clever enough. You could make some wings of sorts, because that's like, you know, how birds go, isn't it? Because their bones are so light, and that's how they can take wind and that. So you could theoretically
they can take wind. Just the way you said that. It's not just that, it's their aerodynamics and their muscle density and their feathers and all that
exactly,
sort of stuff,
but so. It doesn't matter, does it? Because
you could just float. Yeah, you could be lighter than air, so you could just float away,
or you could jump and then what are they called? Is it base jumpers? Where they've got like they jump really high and they've got the the flying squirrel suits.
You'd have to be really careful with it though, because if you mistimed it when you came down to land, you break both your legs. So you would have to be super careful with it, because you're not a superhero.
Not if you change them to be really heavy. Stronger. If you change it, surely.
It might change. We haven't specified. It could change the density, to a degree.
So if it did work that way, you just make them really heavy again. This is going to work, boom.
Well, we didn't specify it with
break the floor.
Yeah, I'd pick that. What about you, Lou? What would you pick?
I'm kind of indifferent on the whole subject.
I know it's a bit of a weird one, but these are all these would you rathers are a bit hard, aren't they? So it's just for the lols. Yeah.
No, I just think they both sound lame. I'm not really interested, I think.
Or you could be, like, could change the size of stuff, then if there's, like, a broken dam or something, and, I don't know. I'm just trying to think of a more,
Well, you could just get a bit of concrete and make it as big as you wanted. It would have potential. I mean, like I was saying with food, maybe it would be better to do that because you could feed everybody who's starving.
Yeah.
Or
so the wait list would
gold?
Be more like
what about gold?
It'd
be really weird though, because you pass over this gold bar and they'd be like, "Well, this doesn't weigh very much." So that would be weird.
Yourself, if something is loads larger but weighs the same, are you just spreading out its molecules more?
Yeah.
Have you actually got more gold?
Yeah. So that would be weird, because everybody'd be like, "Oh, your gold probably wouldn't be classified as real gold. It'd be like a new version of fool's gold." So it probably wouldn't be valuable per se.
So the small print, isn't it?
Yeah, it's not specified in these would you rathers I looked up online. So, All right, let's do one more then. Would you rather be attacked by two full-grown lions only with a large knife to defend yourself, or 70 domestic cats and your only weapon is a very vaguely pointy stick? Go.
Do you have any kind of ignition on you?
You mean like a lighter or something? Well, do you normally? If you normally carry one, then yes, that's allowed. If you don't, then no, I don't. So no, I wouldn't.
Downside to quitting smoking all them years ago.
Yeah.
It's pretty much the same question as T-Rex versus Velociraptors, isn't it? I'll take the T-Rex.
I'd say that one's way more sensible. It'd be much easier to hide from a T-Rex, and they're not supposed to run that fast. I think a Velociraptor can outrun them. So.
In offense, we are talking about lions.
Yeah, two lions. You've got a large knife, like let's say something in between like a Bowie knife and a machete, so it's pretty big, so you could definitely...
You might be able to work out patterns, because like, they are, obviously lions work together, don't they? Mm. So you might be able to establish their body language or their, if you know, or something like that. Whereas cat, have you been scratched by a cat or bit like that? It hurts.
Well, maybe you don't have to fight them, but you would be constantly chased by them and stuff. So maybe you could run away and climb up a tree. It's like how you want to do it tactically. It's up to you.
If you got killed by the lions, it would be relatively quick.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas it could take a full hour for some of these small cats to kill you.
Yeah, but think about the news, the headline, person killed by two full-grown lions. Oh, that's pretty juicy. But what about a person killed by 70 domestic cats? That'll be all over the world. So, epitaph.
I'm not bothered about my legacy. I'll take the lions, definitely.
I'd take the lions for that reason as well, because they'd be like, do you know what? Good on her for putting up a fight. Whereas some Muppet got eaten by cats, like domestic
really
cats.
Here's the deal, though. I don't think I'd have any chance to be able to take on two full-grown lions. I'm pretty certain they'd fuck me up and kill me. However, I reckon I could take 70 domestic cats. I mean, I'm going to get fucked up and I'll need to be in hospital. But I reckon I could take 70 cats with a sharp stick. Yeah.
70?
Yeah, but think about it. With a sharp stick, I can go boom, boom. I can probably get one dead or mortally wounded every two strikes.
Yeah, but if they all rush you, I think it's game over.
Yeah, but it's kind of tactical as well. Like, it's the same thing. Maybe it depends where you are, but maybe you could climb a tree and then kill off a couple at a time.
Yeah, I was going to say, it depends on you. depends on your environment. If you're
you're not per se. It says you're attacked. It doesn't say you have where you're fighting them per se,
in the wild.
Or what tactics. You don't have to per se engage with them in a battle. Maybe you could just run, or you know. But they're going to be constantly chasing you. It's like horde mode in a game. They're going to be after you, so you have to, you know, choose.
I'd definitely take lions then, especially if it's male lions, because they're really lazy. So they'd give up.
Maybe,
I reckon.
Plus, we pick the lions so we can have one each.
Yeah, we could tame them.
Tame them?
Yeah. Maybe not tame them, but at least come to like a mutual understanding where, like, you know, he doesn't eat me.
Isn't the Jungle Book or Far Cry Primal, you know.
Where's the small print saying it isn't, mate?
Well,
I don't see it.
So this is vaguely.
Damn line,
this one's vaguely
line.
Based in our reality, so, you know.
I still don't see it in small print.
Unless you can commune. Can you commune with animals as of now?
Yeah. Have you ever tried? She might be able to.
Well,
and why would I tell you if I could?
If there's any time to try.
You'd exploit me.
I don't know.
If you got money out of it, you wouldn't exploit me.
No, Hitlers don't do such things. I'll have you know. How dare you?
Yeah.
So no, I'd pick the cats. I reckon I could take 70 cats. Like I'm saying, I'd be messed up, but I reckon I could take them. Wow, that's this week's ReconCast done and dusted. I hope you enjoyed our shenanigans and tomfoolery. And feel free to join in with our nonsense by posting your ideas for topic 3 in the comments. And as well as a name check, your topic could feature in an upcoming episode. Anywho, if you enjoyed this video, please like, comment, share, and subscribe for more BS of a similar nature. Thank you, and goodbye.